New Zealanders enjoy lots of sports, but there are some we're really, really good at. Cricket, rugby and gumboot throwing. Because if it weren't for your gumboots, where would you be?
New Zealanders excel at this demanding sport. One thrower totally dominates the women's scene, and tonight she gives us an insight into what it takes to make it to the top. Julian Lee filed this special report.
The Taihape International Airport, with the might of Ruapehu towering above it. With its mixture of subalpine business, leisure and pleasure, it's no wonder they call Taihape the Zurich of the South Pacific. Despite the glamour, it's this structure which reminds us all of the permanent mark this place has left on the international sporting scene.
Gumboots, they are swell, because they keep out the water.
And Taihape, you're allowed to throw them wherever you want, or?
Well, I suppose you can if you can get away with it.
No wonder it's home to New Zealand's largest and most popular throwing lane, and New Zealand's longest ever reigning champ, Kristin Churchward.
So you, what's your record? It's 36 metres?
Yeah, just over 36 metres.
And that's just way past the net there. That... Oh. Oh, that's a good... That is almost your record.
This is an official international sport with tightly controlled rules.
One man on a mission was Olympic decathlete Brent Newdick, desperate to win back his national title after losing it last year.
Curly Troon, New Zealand Boot Throwing Association president.
You elected president, or did you seize the reins of power, or how did that work?
Bullied into it, I suppose.
There's heaps of ways, but I hold it like that.
Like that. What do you call this? The thumb grip or something like that?
Yeah.
It's like a, just, like a discus.
Yeah, and just sort of
boot first.
Yeah, toe bit first and just...
You're making it sound so easy. I know there's all this technique. Like, is it an arc, like up, or is it...
Yeah, I suppose, like, 45 degrees.
Oh, that's a good throw.
In this rapidly evolving sport, these records have already been smashed.
So you're the longest record holder in New Zealand history. That's pretty impressive, isn't it? So you do a spin.
Yeah, so a bit like a discus spin.
What is it?
Oh!
Out this way.
Yeah.
And go one.
Yeah.
And two.
Yeah, how far can you throw?
Usually between around 35. Biggest throws, 38.7. I'd dearly like to get to 40 metres one day, but I think time's on my side. Might be running out of time for that.
So how did you get into this in the first place? I mean, growing up in Taihape helps.
From like 10 or something I've been throwing.
Yeah?
Because they used to block off the main street and you used to throw up there and it'd land on like the shop windows and roofs.
Oh, really?
And things. Yeah, yeah.
Does Curly give you any tips, or is he sort of like a coach?
Yeah, he chucks a few pointers in here and there.
I think if you overtrain and you overthink,
yeah,
you're going to get it as far.
Right.
Yeah, we've got a lot of good throwers, but they just overthink.
And like the throw of a rubber boot down a grass lane out the back of Taihape, we too hurtle boot first down the road of life. In both cases, the key to winning is not to try too hard. Otherwise, you end up in a wire mesh fence, or even worse, on the road, awaiting the unforgiving tyres of a local sheep farmer's ute.
Yeah, interesting. I mean, Kristin's very good at that, obviously, but look, I personally would go heel first. I wouldn't go... toe first.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? What's you thinking there?
I just think you want the weight coming in from in behind the heel. I mean, look, I obviously Curly knows what he's doing. He hasn't hit 40 metres yet, has he?
Well, so does Kristin.
Yeah.
So you're just sort of mansplaining how to throw a gumboot to a gumboot champion.
I would go that. I would just go that way, and I'd also go with the